My name is Irene, and in this video, we're going to talk about how we can create extremely custom material surfaces in Sketchup. So let's get to it. All right, so I'm going to be working with a space of 10 by 10. This could be a floor, this could be a wall, this could be anything, but I'm going to be restricting myself to a 10 by 10. I am going to pretend to say that it is a floor, and I am going to pretend that I want to have a custom tile pattern in my floor. Now, this is not necessarily an everyday situation, especially if you're working in residential design. It can be more common if you're working with commercial, hospitality, but basically the idea is that sometimes when you're working with materials, it's not just going to be like, ah, yes, I get a single tile and I put that single tile in a stack pattern and that's the end of the story and that's all I'm going to be doing with my material. Sometimes you are going to have projects where you want to create a custom pattern or a custom placement of that material. So what I want to show you here is two different methods, two different ways that we can do this. So the first one is going to be using lines and faces to split the surface that you're working with in order to create multiple subdivisions where you can have different materials. So this method has its pros and cons. The pro is that it's going to be the fastest and it's going to be the one that gives you the most freedom. But the con is going to be kind of what we talked about all the way back to our fast and dirty versus slow and clean, because now you're going to have this surface subdivided into smaller faces, so to speak. There is going to be the chance that when you go to deform one of them, you may do something that you didn't want to do. So I just want to kind of like point out what are the potential issues. So let's say that for this pattern here, I basically want to do a border detail. What I'm going to be doing here is I'm going to start by creating three materials. I'm going to have three tiles. So I'm going to have a bigger border, then I want to have a smaller border that is going to be mosaic, and then finally I want to have kind of like my central or main pattern. So I'm going to start here, and this is going to be my border big. Very good names. I am very good with names. Let's say I can't recognize them anymore. So who am I working with here? So I'm going to be loading this guy here. And let's say that these tiles, remember, if you want to make sure that your tile is exactly the size that you want it to be, you basically have to count how many tiles you have in the sample image and then multiply that by whatever size the tiles are. So I want these tiles to be 12 by 12, so a feet by a feet. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So my sample here is going to be 6 feet by 6 feet. I'm going to go okay. And that is going to be my first material. I'm not going to go ahead and apply it. I'm going to leave it there for a second. And I'm going to create my second material, which is going to be my mosaic. And I'm going to load this image for this guy. Now, this guy's going to be a little bit trickier to size. I don't want to count mosaics. I'm kind of lazy. You should know that about me by now. So I'm just going to leave it whatever size it is. And I will use my texture position in model to scale this one. So I'm just going to say, okay. And my final image is going to be kind of like my accent tile or my main tile. So this is going to be my pattern tile. Let's call it tile. And I'm going to load it in. And that is going to be this guy here. Now this guy here has some issues that I will need to fix if I want to work with it. Now let's say that this tile is going to be a little bit bigger. Let's say that it's going to be a 2 by 2 because it's like a single tile in this entire image. Okay, so I have my three tiles. So before I start working with my pattern here, I need to fix this guy because you're going to see, I'm going to draw it here to the side so you can see the problem. If I just apply this guy, see my tile ends there and then I have a wide pattern, which is bad. We already talked about this. So here's a cool trick. You can fix a texture by making it a kind of like a one-off, so to speak. So basically I can draw a rectangle that is 2 feet by 2 feet. I'm going to apply my tile texture here. I'm going to use the position tools and the pins to kind of like fix it. So let's say we're going to go unfix pins because I'm going to be distorting. So you're going to go there. You're going to go here. You are going to go over here. And then you are going to go, let's say there. Perfect. And now all I need to do is stretch it so it fits my new position. There we go. So now it's just one tile per texture. And what you can do here now is you can right click and you can say make unique texture. So what this is going to do, pay attention to the material folder, is going to create a new version of the material that doesn't have the pattern. So check it out. If I come here and now I select this texture here, see, this is my iteration. See, this one doesn't have the problem. So that's a really easy way to fix that excess whiteness that we don't want to have. So with my texture fixed, I'm going to get rid of this guy. I'm going to delete it. Yes, I no longer need you. And this guy can just be tile 1. Perfect. So, okay, now I can get started. So let's say that for my texture here, I want to have a border of these big tile all around. So remember, the tile itself is 1 feet by 1 feet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the offset tool, quick key F, to create an offset of 1 feet. Basically, you want the offset to be a multiple of the size of the tile. So if I would want to have a row of two, then it would be 1 feet, 1 feet, 2 feet. So once I've done that, I'm going to select my texture and I'm going to apply it only to this border face. Click. And now what I'm going to do is use my texture position to align it. I don't need the loose pins anymore. And I can come here and check it out. If you've done your sizing correctly, what you're going to see is that your image perfectly aligns with the placement of your geometry. So it really looks like the image is starting and ending. And again, this is what I was talking about in a previous video. I can literally come here and count how many tiles I need. I need like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 by 10 by 10. So I can say I need 10, 20, 30, 40. Give it a couple more for like waste and then you're good to go. So this is really cool. Now let's see what happens with the mosaic. Now mosaic is usually going to come, I'm trying to remember, it's going to come in 1 inch and 2 inch. Let's say that I want my mosaic to be 2 inch, and let's say that I want to have 2 rows of it. So if I want to have 2 rows of 2 inch mosaic, this is going to be 4 inches. So I'm going to go with my offset again and I'm going to do 2 inches. See, now I'm going to apply my mosaic material to this border. This is why I wasn't really bothered with like scaling it, because what I can do now that I understand there's a logo. Whoops, Mosaic House, thank you for your contribution. Now what I can do, this is the other cool thing, I can use the images to scale my material. So I can pick this pin here and I can say that I'm gonna put it to 2 mosaics. And now when I bring it down, I just need to bring it down until I can see 2 of them. There, perfect. And now what's going to happen is that I just need to verify that my alignment is still good when I get to the end of my image. It's a little bit off because the image is not perfect. It's a little bit, you know, not even because it's not digital. It's an actual picture of tile. Finally, you're just going to do the same thing for this guy here. Oh, this guy here changed the size because remember, we cut it a little bit. So this guy's supposed to be 2 by 2. And when I come here and I apply it, I am going to once again use my texture position and then place it and align it. And once again, it seems like we have a little bit of a discrepancy with the sizing. Now, in this case, this is actually accurate because remember, my mosaic took 2 inches and 2 inches, which means that now I cannot have a simple tile. So check it out. In this case, what I could do is basically I'm going to have to cut this tile all around. Like I would have to do it in real life. So I can use my guidelines to basically find the middle of my room, basically. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my position right in the center there. And look at that. I'm basically getting the same cut all around, and then I can delete my guides. So as you can see, you can go extremely hard with the customization. After I place my textures, I can come here and say like, you know what? I want these materials to match a little bit more. So check this out. I can select this tile here and I want to say that I want this color to match closely this like taupe-ish grayish here. So I'm going to come here. I'm going to check on colorize, and then I'm going to click on picking a pixel on the screen, and I'm going to say this guy here. And look at that. Now they are the same color. Let's do the same thing with these like mosaic and this green here. So I'm going to pick my mosaic here and I am going to pick pixels. And let's say I'm going to pick this pixel. Oh, because I didn't do colorize. See, this is why we do colorize, reset, colorize, pixel. And this one is just ugly for some reason. So I might edit it like manually. I'm not sure why it's not working the way that I would want to. What if I do it manually? It's not perfect, but it will do. So this is method one. As you can see, you can very quickly, very easily create a very custom pattern. But the problem is that this is only really going to be for like one-off scenarios. So for example, here, like you have a border tile with like a different pattern. Or for example, this was like super popular some years ago where you basically had the hexagon tiles, like you know what decade I'm talking about, and basically you would have the hexagon tile meeting a wooden floor and they would just basically cut it in the shape of the hexagon tile. So that would be another application, but it's very one-off. Now what would happen if instead you simply want to create a pattern that then you want to see repeating in your surface, and you just want it to repeat on its own? You don't want to have to draw each and every line. Let's say that I want to create a pattern where I have one row of this tile, then I have another row of this tile that is stacked, and then I have a line of the mosaic as a ribbon, and then it restarts. What do I do in that case? Well, in that case, you are going to use a tool called Combine Textures. So now I'm going to give a word of warning. I don't know why, but this tool seems to be a little bit hit or miss. Sometimes I will do like a beautiful, very detailed pattern, and then when I combine the textures, it goes to hell and it kind of like messes them up. I'm not entirely sure why that happens. If anyone knows, let me know, because I'm super confused about why it does that. But let's see how this works. Now, the things that you will need for this case will be, number one, you need to know what is the repeat of the tile, and you will see why in a second. So again, we said that it was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So basically, I'm going to create here a rectangle that is going to be 6 feet by 1 foot, okay? And I'm going to place my tile here, and I'm going to manage the placement so it starts and ends like perfectly aligned. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create a copy of this tile. I'm going to put it a little bit away so it doesn't automatically merge, because basically what I want to do now is I want to shift it. Remember, I don't want to like stack it. I want kind of like a brick pattern. So I am going to shift this guy half the size of a tile. So that would be 6 inches. Okay. Now here's the thing. Remember, the tile is a repeating pattern. So if now I move, so the form, basically what I'm going to get is a seamless tile, because what's going to happen is that this tile here will match this tile here. And one way that you can verify that is because if I select it and I make a copy and put it, you are going to see that it just repeats properly. Okay. So this is how you can kind of like shift your image for a repeating seamless tile. Now I'm going to bring this guy down and I'm going to stack it. I'm not really seeing, oh no. Yeah. I'm seeing a little bit of the white. And now I'm basically going to do the same thing for my mosaic. I'm going to do a line of mosaic that is going to be, we said 6 feet by 2 inches, and I am going to apply my mosaic material. We're going to put it here, and again, texture position, just to make sure that my placement is as ideal as possible. I'm going to reset here because I'm not sure what I'm looking at yet. Ooh, I wish I could reset my pins, but it's not going to let me. So you know what? Let's start here at the beginning of my image. There you go. And we're going to put this guy here, and then I am going to pick this pin here. And I'm going to put it here at the top, because again, remember, we're measuring based on the 2 pins. So it doesn't really matter where these other guys are. So keep in mind, like the position, scaling, rotating, those pins don't have to be in a perfect square. You can just put them anywhere that they will help you. And there you go. So this is, that's not perfect. I'm going to pretend that it is. Again, the image is not great. Clearly, there's a logo in it. So now I have my pattern. And basically what I would want to see is that if my this pattern is going to cover a greater surface, technically what should happen is that it should repeat like this, and then it should repeat like this here, and so on and so forth, right? So what I can do is I can take all of the faces that make my pattern. I'm going to right click, and you're going to find this option here called Combine Textures. Now, it's going to give you a message that is going to ask you basically if you want to erase the interior edges. So basically what this is asking you is, do you want to convert the current number of faces that you have selected into a single face that has that texture applied to them, or do you want to keep them? My personal recommendation is that you want to keep them. So if for whatever reason in the future you want to change your pattern, you don't have to start from scratch. So I do not want to erase my interior edges. And these might look like you did nothing. Like it's still the faces, it's still the positions, it's still all the same. But if I go to select, now you're gonna see that I have a new pattern that is those combined textures. So check it out. If now I come here, and I'm gonna make another 10 by 10 rectangle. So I'm gonna go 10 feet by 10 feet, and I go here, I can now apply this repeating texture, see? And when I place with my position and I place it correctly, look at that, see? So you can create custom patterns in 2 different ways. The advantage of this one is because it's a single texture, you don't have to worry about accidentally moving or deleting or deforming things. So it is a little bit more versatile. I really like this when I have, again, just like a simple kind of interlocking or a simple kind of like edge detailing in a tile where it's not a one-off. It's more like it's repeating several times, but it's kind of annoying to do it manually. Okay. To finish off, since we're talking about complex patterns, I want to talk about one really big and important issue that we have when we work with patterns, and that is overlapping patterns. So let's say I'm going to turn this into a group. I don't know. It's, oh, you know what? Let's have some fun. I'm going to select these and I'm going to rotate them. So it's basically that was my floor and this is my wall. Yay. That looks kind of cool. So let's say that this is a room, a bathroom probably. And I want to have, so I'm going to make this into a group and I want to have a rug in this room because nothing spells I have stupid amounts of money as having a super intricate tile pattern in the floor and then covering it with a rug. But I've seen this in real life, so why not? So I'm going to make myself a 6 by 9 rug so we can perfectly cover that beautiful pattern that we spent hours making. 6 by 9, 6 by 9, 6, 9 feet. Nope, this is 6 by 9. Okay. And now I'm going to create a new material for my rug. I'm going to load my rug image. It's going to be this guy here. We already did this in a previous video, so I'm not going to be super precious about making this rug the most perfect rug ever. I just want it to look like a rug somewhat. So I'm going to come here and I'm going to stretch this guy, and that's going to be my rug. Now, when I bring my rug into my room, this is what's going to happen. Oh, Christ. What the hell is going on? My computer is having a seizure. So what's happening here is that, remember, these two faces are just that, faces. So what happens is that when you have two faces and you put them one on top of the other, basically SketchUp doesn't by default know who it should be showing you. It doesn't know who goes on top of who. So how are we gonna solve this? There's two ways. There's the right way and then there's the wrong way. So let's first do the wrong way. So if you're in a hurry and you're desperate, what you could do is select your rug, pick it up with the move key, and just move it up literally a millimeter. So 1 mm and then enter. And that will fix the problem because basically now the rug is on top of the tile face. But the problem with this is that the texture is no longer kind of like touching the surface. And if for whatever reason you have to move this rug, you're going to see that it's immediately going to give you the same issue. So this is a temporary solution. And what we want is a permanent solution. So the permanent solution is going to be to give a thickness to your material. So you're going to do this if you have a sheet of paper on a desk, if you have a poster on a wall, and if you have a rug. Now, you don't have to push-pull this like super, this looks ridiculous. You just have to give it a little bit of thickness. I find that 1 millimeter is a little bit too, like you're going too far. Something like 1/4 inch or literally like 5 millimeters is better. Basically, you want to be able to see that it has a little bit of thickness because that's going to make it a lot easier for you to pick up and move around that geometry later. So see, all I need to do is give it 1/4 inch thickness, and now my problem is solved. But also, if I want to move this geometry, I'm not going to get, oh, I picked it up on the wrong place. If I pick it on the bottom corner, now I'm not going to get that problem because it is a geometry with its own basically like thickness, and that will make it so it is always sitting on top of your floor. With that, we have reached the end of this video. I hope you found it interesting. I hope you find it helpful. If you have any questions, by all means, feel free to add them in the comments. Give this video a like, maybe subscribe. But otherwise, thank you very much for joining in. Thank you very much for sticking through, and I will see you in the next one. Have a good one. Bye.